What's up guys, Darkbreaker here, and for today's video we are playing Pain in the mid lane. Since you guys have requested me to play Pain more, I haven't been playing Pain since the release because my Pain is super bad. 50% win rate, we just inted all the time. Like, I played him a few times in standard games, but honestly, yeah, my Pain is super bad. But we just got some tips from Vekos. Vekos, one of the best mid laners, he just gave me some tips. So obviously, we will play much better now knowing those tips. And I mean, the only tip that I just got from him was that you always attack the minions from behind, so you end up in front of them. So when you clear the wave, you go behind the minions, attack them, and then you are towards your lane, towards your tower side. So you don't end up being at the enemy side, so you get free poke and so on. It's just a slight tip. And for the build, we just copied 07's build, Zweihänder, into Spooky Mask, into Hercules, into Hecatus, and then into Apocalypse and Arctic Orb, and then finish Spooky Mask into Void Staff. What's the name again? I never play mages. I don't even know the name anymore. It's Batman. I don't play mages, so I forgot all the names. So anyways, in the early game, Pain, one of the best gankers. Let's see. Okay. Richter missed his double dash, but we still managed to get the kill. That's not too bad. Vekos is clearing. I think he cleared the mid lane just there. So we have time and we don't necessarily have to go to the mid lane right now. Okay. Let's get the HP regen and now try to clear the wave. Let's see. I go right behind the minion wave and then I will dash forward, basically. You dash always behind, but because you're behind, you will dash forward, okay? Best explanation. Let's go. See? I stay behind him and now I dash. I dash behind, but because I'm behind, I dash forward. Okay, now you guys understand. Let's go. It's just a slight tip, but it makes clearing minion wave easier and you don't get targeted. I think that's a big big tip that I didn't do before. And I always got free poked by the opponent mid laner. Also for the combos, it's pretty simple. You either go S1 in, then S2, and mix your auto attacks in between, and then you can either use your ultimate to jump out again, or you use your ultimate to jump again in and do even more damage, and then use your Arctic Orb. That's option one. That isn't too safe. You can do it in the early game if you're fighting a 1v1, for example. Oh, never mind. Actually, this is the combo that you use most of the times in the late game in the team fights. You just try to pick out one person and then you dash out with the ultimate, because otherwise your ultimate is going to get CC'd most of the times. Or when you jump in, people know, okay, Pain is coming in, and then they just focus all their CC and their burst onto you. So it's better to use your ultimate out in the late game compared to just using your ultimate in. So that's what I like to do. Just in some cases you can use your ultimate in when you know they use already most of their CC and their burst damage skills. And also if you can snipe someone who is super low life, then you can also use it. But besides that, always use your ultimate out. It's just much safer. Okay, let's see. We try to snipe. Boom. S2. And now just S1 auto attack and this guy dies. And we don't even have to use execute. And for the other combo, it's just use your ultimate in, use your S2 auto attack to dash right behind, and then you can use your S1 to escape or either chase the opponent. So those are the two main combos that you use on Pain most of the times. And like I said, the first option is the most safe option that you like to do in the late game team fight, because otherwise I was playing Pain last game against Raz, and whenever I tried to jump in with the ultimate, he would just wait for my ultimate mark and then use his S2 passive ultimate S1, and I just get CC chain, I can't even move. So don't use your ultimate in the late game team fight. It most of the times doesn't work. Ultimate in, S2, S1, boom, execute. We just absolutely melted this guy, and I saw on the minimap that Tulin was moving to the top side, and I was like, okay, our blue buff is up at the same time, so he's probably going for our blue buff. That's some map hacking knowledge that I just gave you. Check the minimap, my boys. Auto attack. I think we were too greedy right there. I might die here for this. Use Arctic Orb. I tried to use the ultimate out, but Florentino knocked us up and we couldn't escape. And I was too greedy. I just died because I wanted the cannon minion. Feels bad, man. Feels bad, man. That was too greedy. Otherwise, we could have just survived easily if I didn't go for the cannon minion. But 100 gold for my shutdown gold. Yeah, it's worth. Nah, it's not worth. We just entered. We totally entered right there. Okay, they got the Abyssal Dragon. Right now I'm doing pretty well, but our Wisp is totally getting destroyed by Hayate. 1v1, 0-3 Wisp right now. She's getting demolished by Hayate somehow. Okay, this guy should die. I'm like, do I need to use ultimate? And then I just cancel it because I saw that Necrof would finish Ryoma anyway, so there was no need. And right now I'm looking, okay, top lane. Maybe we can finish off someone with some ultimate snipes. Okay, ultimate snipe right here. Boom. It's 100% calculated, man. The calculation is unreal. The calculation. Let's go. Let's see what we can do here. Maybe we can try to steal this buff. Okay, let's jump onto here. S2. Boom. Execute. We got the kill, actually. And now let's just run from Ryoma. No, 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 no. Don't go for us. We are... Do you guys know how many games I have on this hero? I have, like, let's say... I have 10 games. I have 10 games. And 6 of those were at the first day when Pain got released. So, I haven't been playing Pain forever because my Pain was so bad. I played him in standard games. And, oh, God. I got a few losing MVPs, but my Pain is just horrible. So I was like, ah, I don't want to play Pain anymore. But you guys have asked me, come on, Dark, we want a new Pain video. I was like, okay, boys, for my viewers, I do anything. I will do another Pain video. Not a problem. And right now I'm just checking the canceling indicator, because I have, when I use the ultimate, I have to drag so far outside of the indicator. I'm like, ah, this is so scuffed, man. Okay, see, that's what I mean. Stay behind, dash forward, easy peasy. Okay, probably having to go back right now, kind of low. And I think Ryoma can just one shot it. Now let's ultimate in, three man, boom. Yeah, let's go. I told you you shouldn't do this because it's kind of risky, but we just sniped him off. Look at us. We sniped, who was it, Tulin. We just sniped Tulin, use S2 and then dash out with our S1. And another tip I can give you is you can bait skills with your S1 because they can target you. So when you're in a seizing, when you are in a sieging position or trying to defend, you can just use your S1, run a bit forward, and just keep doing it to bait the opponents to use their skills. And when someone's getting poked and you see an opening, then of course just use your S1 in, S2, and then use your ultimate to dash out. And Florentino just getting one-shotted. He doesn't have any magic resistance, and we are super fed, so obviously we will one-shot him. Just get Troy. Just get Troy. Without Troy, I would just one-shot you. See, he has Rank Breaker Hercules. He has zero defense against us. So it's super easy for us to kill him. I probably have like true damage right now because I have piercing and he has zero magic resistance. Okay, let's see. I canceled it because I wasn't sure if I can just go in. Let's see if I can find the right opening to jump onto a Hayate. Let's just jump in, jump, execute, and now try to... Okay, we got stunned by Ryoma. Super low life, and we still managed to survive. This was... I mean, if I say calculated, you guys will say, this was luck, this was luck. I mean, it was... Obviously, it was luck. But let me just have some fun and say it was calculated. I mean... The execution was planned, but surviving so low life, that wasn't planned. Because Ryoma stunned me during my first ultimate try. But we still managed to escape with a sliver of health. Just 1% HP, and we still managed to survive. Super lucky, to be honest. Okay, let's see if I can... I bet this is going to be greedy, but whatever. Kill him, and oh god, we... No, she cancelled our ultimate! Annette, pro player! Too good! She cancelled our ultimate! And by accident, I jumped over the wall and hit Annette because I wanted to hit Florentino, but he already got bursted by my S1. And then when I already used my S2, I pressed auto-attack and then I just dashed right behind Annette over the wall. And I tried to escape with the ultimate, but Annette just cancelled me. Okay, they are pushing. They probably get the tier 2 tower. Maybe even the tier 3 tower. They have, okay, they have one cannon minion that is super low. Okay. Okay, map pack move failed. Map pack 101. Didn't work out. I tried to snipe Tulen. I thought he would go from there back, but yeah, I should activate my map pack. It was scuffed. If I had map pack activated like I usually do, I would have hit him. But unfortunately, my map pack skills were kind of off and I didn't hit him correctly. Feels bad, man. Feels bad, man. Okay. Yeah, Lumbo is getting caught and this is looking bad. They can siege now. This is looking pretty bad, because our tank died, Richter died. I'm like, okay, this is going to be super hard right now. I'm just looking at the canceling. Okay, this is going to be super hard if we can. Okay, never mind. Dash to war. Okay, we totally missed, but we can kill Florentino still. Nice. We didn't have to use execute as well, and that survived super low life. They will probably go for Dark Slayer right now. Maybe someone is trapping in the bush right here. So I'm just using my S1 forward to check. Yep, they are on it. And I feel sad because we just lost Slayer again. And with the Slayer, they should be able to get the next tier 3 tower. Let's just wait here and camp. Someone's going for the small camp, obviously. Jump onto Hayate. And we get the kill onto him. And the Hayate is actually a Conqueror as well, so that's why he's absolutely smurfing on the Wisp right now. He's 11-4. He's mad. Wait, he has Troy. Come on, don't get Troy. Okay, let's see if we can snipe again. Use our ultimate. Boom, S2. Now dash out. Okay, no one is blocking the Tulen ultimate, and look at our HP now. That was super close. I don't know why they didn't try to block, at least for me. But we got 2 kills out of this fight. I think the others might be able to push the tier 3 tower. This game is super close. 25-22. Enemy Hayate is carrying pretty hard, and in our team, I'm doing pretty well right now. Let's get Arctic Orb, clear this bot wave, maybe go for Dragon afterwards. 13 kills, pain. We have 50% win rate on this hero, let's go. And I have to say, without trying to brag or something, I would say this gameplay, my pain is pretty clean. My pain is pretty clean actually, the team fights. I did a few good ultimate engages so far. Yeah, I'd say pretty solid, considering the amount of games I have on him, and usually I'm inting on Pain, so kind of surprising. I didn't play Pain for 1 year, probably. Look at our damage! We just absolutely bursted Florentino, we just one-shotted him, and now ultimate, boom, S2, one-shot Hayate as well. Let's go. Now I'm just going back, and I probably write to them right now that they should try to finish the game, since Hayate, their enemy carry is death. They have a window to finish the game, maybe. Okay, two people are still dead, minion wave is coming in. Okay, Vejos is pushing at the bot lane. Top wave is crashing onto the tier 2 tower, so he is already rotating to the top tower. This is pretty good so far. We got two tier 3 towers. I know the question is just, okay, can we finish the game now? Use the ultimate in. This time I will use the ultimate in to do a lot of damage. Use my Arctic Orb quickly. And S1. We still managed to burst. We still managed to get our S1 off onto the higher T. And he dies immediately. And this is the game. Super close game. Anyways, I hope you guys enjoyed this gameplay. I would say this gameplay was pretty amazing of us playing Pain. And if you guys enjoyed this gameplay and want to see more commentaries like this, then it would be lovely if you guys leave a like and subscribe. And I wish you guys an awesome day. Bye-bye. Bye-bye.